Trello automation with checklists is getting better all the time. Did you know that you can create checklist item due dates based off of a custom field date? I had a reader ask me about this recently. She wanted to make a checklist with items that were due relative to a closing date on the card, and sure enough, Trello's got your back. So first, to set this up, you're gonna need a custom field. So from anywhere on the board, click these three dots, go to your custom fields, create a new field. We're gonna call it closing, and you need it to be a date field. So go ahead and create that field. Next, head over to automation by clicking this lightning bolt at the top of your board. You can go ahead and click rules. Now think about how you wanna trigger the automation for creating the checklist items and assigning the due dates. I probably would recommend doing it based on when that custom field is set. Just that way you know the data is there so it can actually create off of it, but you may do it based off something else like when you add a label to it or something like that. So let's go ahead and hit create automation and add trigger. And I'm gonna go over to these field sections and I'm going to look for when custom fields, click closing, are completed, click that plus button. And that's very important, make sure you click that plus button so it adds that as the trigger there. So next we need to add an action. So go to the checklist section here and you can see all sorts of things. We're going to add an item. You don't need to already have a checklist on the card, it will create it as you do it here. So I'm gonna say first thing and go ahead and call it closing or whatever. Again, this checklist doesn't have to exist already, it will create it, but you will want to make sure you use this for every item. So click that. Make sure, again, to click that plus blue button and scroll down to click add another action. And now let's look for this one where it says set item due now. Go ahead and click that now and scroll down a bit and you'll see you've got some other options where it has like on the date in custom field. And that's where you're gonna set your custom field, but then you're gonna click this calendar button because you can say plus or minus however many days, and this is how you set it relative to that. So let's say I actually wanna do this first thing 5 days before closing. I'm not a realtor, so I actually don't know. Maybe you'd probably do something a month before closing. I don't know, but you can change this and make this whatever you need it to be. So make sure to say closing minus 5 days. Click this gray plus button here, and it's gonna add it to this section here. Click the blue plus button again. And so now scroll up and you can see our workflow here. And basically when the custom fields closing are completed, add an item called first thing to a checklist called closing, set the item due to the date in custom field closing minus 5 days. So if it's September 12th, it will set it to September 7th in this case. And I assume you probably want to add more items, so you just need to kind of scroll down and rinse and repeat. I'll go through another action here. Let's say checklist, maybe we want to add second thing, and thankfully it's going to save that name of the checklist there, so just click that blue button, add another action, remember to set that due date, and you can click this, go ahead and hit that X to reset it, and click now. Closing due date minus, let's say we want this one in 3 days, click that, blue plus button, and there you go. When you have added all of the items, hit save, and you're ready to try it out. Go over here. So now let's create a new house item here. Let's open it up, let's go ahead and set that closing date. We'll go ahead and make it like the 4th, hit save, and it's gonna take it a second. Trello automation's been running a little slow for me sometimes. So notice we've got our first item here and it's went ahead and added that date there, which is 5 days before that. And it's taking a second, but I bet if I refresh, yep, there it is right there. Second thing, and it's got that date of 3 days before. If you need to edit any of the items, you'll need to go back to the automation and do that. So to just do that, click these lightning bolts, go over to rules, and you should be able to find your rule. If you have a lot, you can just click enabled and it's gonna help clean up that list for you. So you can go click edit in there and you can just change the text right in here. You don't have to actually like delete the rule or anything. You can change the text of what you want to be there and it's gonna apply for the future ones. I don't believe there's a way to do it from templated checklist items because unless you want everything to be in that checklist to be exactly 5 days before the closing date, because the cascading items will do the same thing to each action. And what I mean by that is, let's go to cascade and for each checklist item, let's do something. And you might be like, now that's where I will just go to checklist and set item due. And you can totally do this if everything is the same. So for instance, if every single item you want to be plus or minus whatever, 5 days, that's gonna work for this. But if you need one item to be due 3 days before and one item to do 5 days before, et cetera, that's where you're gonna not be able to use like a single checklist that you just apply. You're gonna need to actually build each individual item here in automation. So I hope this helps. If you have more questions about setting relative due dates, I've got some other videos I'm going to link to in the descriptions. And I recently wrote a whole issue of my Trello newsletter all about how you can do some really cool stuff with these due dates. And so definitely check that out. I'll put that link in the description. And you know the drill. If you enjoyed this, if you found it useful, please like and subscribe. That helps more people find it and helps me know it's worthwhile for me to keep making these videos. So thank you so much, and I'll see you later.